Democratic Alliance leader John Steenhuisen believes that Bonginkosi Madikizela's downfall came from within the party. After 12 years in office, Madikizela resigned last month as a Western Cape MEC and as the DA's provincial leader after lying about having a degree. Now, because of this, the DA is auditing the credentials of its office-bearing party members. Steenhuisen sat down for an exclusive interview with ETV News' Graeme Raubenheimer to discuss his own qualifications and his aspirations in the upcoming municipal elections.
I was personally very, very sad about it because here is a talented, exceptionally gifted leader.
DA leader John Steenhuisen believes Bonginkosi Madikizela did the honourable thing by resigning. Madikizela was vying to be the DA's pick for Cape Town mayor, coming up against the incumbent Dan Plato and MP Jordan Hill Lewis.
I definitely do think it was an attempt, and I think it was an internal attempt that highlighted that CV. Well, it obviously would have come from one of the camps that were involved in the elections. Given the timing, etc., I definitely think that it was an internal leak.
Besides the audit of all CVs, Steenhuisen says the cases of alleged misrepresentations of qualifications in the DA, including that of Chief Whip Natasha Mazzoni, are now being investigated. But with a poor showing in by-elections in recent months, is the qualification saga hurting the DA ahead of the polls?
I think it's going to be a lot harder election for us this term, and we don't have Jacob Zuma, who used to be the DA's best membership recruiter, best fundraiser, and best vote getter.
But so does that put you at risk of losing those key measurables?
Well, I don't think so, because I think that people are fed up with the lack of service delivery in other parts of the country.
And what about Steenhuisen's credentials? His critics often bash him for just having matric.
So I studied politics to third year level at UNISA. Nothing I learnt in any of those textbooks has ever stood me in any stead in the real world of politics.
What about the argument that being a white male in a position of power, of privilege, that you should have had something of a tertiary education, that you owe it to yourself to get that?
But why should I do that? Winston Churchill never had it. Bill Gates didn't have it. Jack Dorsey, founded Twitter, never had it. I don't see the same things being shown to them.
The DA will kick off its national election campaign this weekend with what it's calling the country's biggest online political rally. Graeme Raubenheimer, Parliament.